What's up, family? Welcome back to the channel, man. It's your boy, Mr. Twat. Today. Hey, skirt, man. Check this out. Yo, we got a video today. We about to get into it. Now, remember, this is your first time on the channel. Make sure you go ahead and subscribe and join the What's Up family. We are literally the latest family on YouTube, and that's a fact. Also, before we get started, put a like on this video. Remember, if you got a video you want me to react to, get down in the comment section. Let me know, and I will get to it, man. Let's go ahead and get into this reaction.
في حاجات ممنوعه في اسرائيل، ممنوعه منعا باتا، زي الجمبري والكابوريا والقراميط. اي حاجه تطلع من البحر ملهاش قشر، اللي هي الفلوس بتاعت السمك، تبقى محرمه حسب الشريعه اليهوديه.
Today we're going to answer an important health question. Does religion play a major role in your overall health, specifically when it relates to the ratio of omega-6 fatty acids to omega-3 fatty acids in your diet? Let's take a look at some disturbing changes in health that have been taking place over the last 65 years or so. Developed countries around the world have seen a major increase in autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, vasculitis, celiac disease, and type 1 diabetes. Research published in 2015 in the International Journal of Celiac Disease by Dr. Aaron Lerner at Israel's Technion Israel Institute of Technology suggests three major environmental factors are strongly suspected to drive these: infections, ecology, and nutrition. Allergies have also been rising rapidly. One in five children are diagnosed with some type of allergic disease, including asthma, atopic dermatitis, and allergic rhinitis, according to Professor Innes Asher from the University of Auckland in the 1998 edition of the Journal of Clinical and Experimental Allergy. In fact, allergies can now be deemed to have become an epidemic as they've increased so significantly. Professor Thomas Bieber at the Department of Dermatology and Allergy at the University of Bonn is considered to be one of the most famous dermatologists in Germany today. His paper, published in the New England Journal of Medicine in 2008, reveals 15 to 30% of children suffer from atopic dermatitis, a number that has tripled over the past 30 years. Dr. Valma Harjutsalo at the Folkhälsan Research Center in Finland stated in The Lancet in 2008 that type 1 diabetes has now become a serious problem affecting children at a much younger age than ever before, especially in Europe. Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, and primary biliary cirrhosis, three different forms of irritable bowel disease, are also rising at an alarming rate. Interestingly, during this same time, a wide variety of infectious diseases have been on the decline, thanks mostly to vaccines, antibiotics, and improved hygiene habits. This has led many scientists to look at diet as the cause of these increases, specifically the proportion of omega-3 fatty acids to omega-6 fatty acids. Dr. Artemis Simopoulos is the founder and president of the Center for Genetics, Nutrition and Health in Washington, D.C. She's published a lot of research into the relation between inflammatory and autoimmune diseases and the ratio between dietary omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids. She states that the optimal ratio of omega-6, which is inflammatory, to omega-3, which is non-inflammatory, should be 4:1 or lower. The problem is that in most Western diets, the ratio is currently an extremely unhealthy 15:1 or higher. This markedly higher ratio of inflammatory omega-6 leads to a host of illnesses and diseases: cardiovascular disease, obesity, rheumatoid arthritis, cancers of many types, depression, etc. These facts are undisputed in the scientific community. Higher amounts of omega-6 fatty acids are killing humans at an astounding rate around the world. Studies published by Dr. Simopoulos since the early 90s also confirm that a high proportion of omega-6 to omega-3 fatty acids causes a dramatic shift in the physiological state of the human body. When omega-6 is more prevalent, pathogenesis of body tissue occurs, including prothrombic, pro-inflammatory, and pro-constrictive states, all of which are the very causes of disease. On the other hand, Dr. Simopoulos says scientists have found that a diet higher in omega-3 fatty acids is therapeutic and preventative. People with inflammatory and immune diseases have been helped by a diet higher in omega-3s, while coronary artery disease, hypertension, cancer, arthritis, autoimmune disorders and other inflammatory diseases are all diminished and even prevented when omega-3s are more prevalent. Since diet has been shown to be a causative factor, one needs to look at specific foods in order to see where the problem lies. Pig, or pork, for example, produces higher levels of omega-6 by synthesis, which is why it has a much higher level of omega-6 fats. Pork contains up to 14.2 grams of omega-6 per 100 grams of fatty acids, in comparison to the meat in cattle or sheep at 2.4 grams and 2.7 grams respectively, as stated by Dr. Michael Enser and his colleagues at the University of Bristol in the Journal of Meat Science in 1996. The reason for this is explained by his university colleague, Professor Jeff Wood, in the 2008 edition of the journal. Professor Wood says it's because all omega-6 fatty acids present in the diet of pigs pass through the stomach unchanged. Then while in the small intestine, they're absorbed into the bloodstream and incorporated into the animal's tissues as is and unchanged. While in ruminants like cattle and sheep, dietary omega-6 fatty acids are degraded into different fatty acids in their stomach, a process called microbial biohydrogenation. Because of this, only a small portion of dietary omega-6 fatty acids, approximately 10%, are made available for incorporation into tissue fats. Meanwhile, rabbit, ostrich and camel have a very attractive omega-6 to omega-3 profile, but they're eaten on a much smaller scale. In fact, after reviewing the nutritional value of rabbit meat from 50 publications, the omega-6 to omega-3 ratio in rabbit flesh makes it very attractive for health purposes. As stated in 2004 by Dr. Sylvie Coombs at Europe's top agricultural research institute and the world's number two center for the agricultural sciences, the INRA. Camel, as well, has been found to have an ideal ratio of omega-6 to omega-3, almost 3-to-1, according to Dr. Omar Abdel Hadi from Sudan's University of Kordofan, writing in the Journal of the Saudi Society of Agricultural Sciences in 2017. Ostrich meat also has a high level of omega-3 fatty acids. Research published in the Journal of Food and Nutrition Research in 2014 by Dr. Xavier Medina and Alicia Aguilar at Spain's University of Catalonia reveals that more than 8% of the polyunsaturated fatty acids in ostrich are omega-3. Scientists like Dr. Klitos Mapier at Stellenbosch University in South Africa have also found that processed beef products, which have had perirenal fat added to them, could possibly be a better source of CLNA, that's conjugated linoleic acid, which has been shown to have anti-inflammatory, anti-carcinogenic and anti-obesity properties. In fact, in his study published in 2014 in the Journal of Animal Science and Biotechnology, Dr. Mapier found that when perirenal fat was added to regular beef hamburger meat, the fatty acid profile or ratio was improved, thus making it much healthier for human consumption. If we look at shellfish now, lobster, crab and crayfish, shrimps and mussels all have a very healthy and attractive omega-3 to omega-6 ratio. This has been demonstrated in a number of articles published by Dr. Sara Barrento at the University of Porto in Portugal and Swansea University in Wales, Dr. Magdalena Stanek at Poland's University of Technology and Life Sciences, and Dr. Sival Denikabasi at Sinop University in Turkey. Their research, published in 2009, 2010 and 2015 respectively, shows that shellfish is even better than rabbit, chicken, lamb and beef at preventing coronary diseases and chronic inflammatory conditions. Paul Jaminet, PhD, is the CEO and founder of a biotech startup developing a vascular therapy for cancer. His wife, Xu Qingxi Jaminet, PhD, is a director and molecular biologist and cancer researcher at both the Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center and Harvard Medical School. These two scientists share a long-standing interest in diet and health, and they're the founders and principals of the Perfect Health Retreat and authors of the Perfect Health Diet series and website. In part two of their book, published online on the 15th of February 2012, They restated that in most countries, pork is either the primary source of omega-6 fats or the second source after vegetable oils. They go on to recommend in their book what they call perfect health diets, a certain dietary strategy. In brief, they say that the highest sources of omega-6, like pork, must be removed or greatly reduced in the human diet, while the sources of omega-3, like seafoods, especially shellfish, must be added in order to stay healthy. A dietary strategy which is already approved and recommended by all doctors, nutritionists, and molecular biologists. An updated dietary strategy which was put by the Holy Quran to all Muslims more than 1400 years ago and which Muslims are ordered to strictly follow. It's becoming clear that religion has its part to play in human health due to the fact that the Jewish, Christian and Muslim religions vary so differently in the type of meat they allow their followers to consume. Science shows that the lower omega-6 levels of fatty acids in the type of meats that the Holy Quran allows Muslims to eat lead to a healthier diet. Over 1400 years ago, the Holy Quran was already mentioning the health qualities of perirenal fat, shellfish, rabbit, ostrich and camel, and also stated that as a firm punishment, Jews were not allowed to eat foods that contained this type of meat or this type of fat. The Holy Quran says in chapter 4, verse 160, made unlawful for them, we deprived the Jews from certain good foods which had been lawful for them before because of the injustice which they had committed and because of their much hindering from the path of God, Allah's way. In chapter 6, verse 146, the Holy Quran also says, we, God, forbade them, the Jews, the fat of the cattle and the sheep, except that which is carried on their backs or in the viscera or mixed with bones. This was a punishment we gave them on account of their rebellion. When we look at the facts, it's quite clear Jews and Muslims are forbidden from eating pork. But amazingly, Jews are also forbidden by the Torah from eating certain healthy foods, which they name not kosher, such as rabbit, ostrich, camel, shellfish, and perirenal fat, which is considered a clear indirect message to Holy Quran to Muslims to add more of these foods to their diet. Christians can eat the same food that Muslims can eat, but they're also allowed to consume pork. Which group is the healthiest? People of the Muslim faith. This leads to a very strong conclusion. People of the Muslim faith, in thanks to their following of the Holy Quran, appear to have been blessed with a much healthier diet and longer, healthier lives. In fact, the diet followed by those of the Muslim faith appears far superior to that of Jews and Christians alike. The reason is simple. The healthy human ratio of omega-3 to omega-6 fatty acids is a very tight window. If the balance is off, even by a small margin, disease and sickness result. It's for this reason that the higher sources of omega-6 must be removed or greatly reduced in the human diet, while the sources of omega-3 must be added in order to stay healthy. So it only makes sense that people of all religions move towards a diet that better reflects the diet in the Holy Quran, a superior, healthier human diet. Muslim countries simply don't suffer such a prevalence of autoimmune diseases or allergies. Be healthy. Eat like a Muslim.
Yo, what's up, family, man? I really like that YouTube channel, man. Make sure y'all subscribe to that channel, man. There is no clash. Like, I really like that YouTube channel. It's just something about watching that lady just talk. And I mean, yeah, she knows what she's talking about. So I really support that channel. I will put the link to the link in the description of the video so you can go watch it yourself and subscribe to their channel. But remember, guys, if this is your first time on the channel, make sure you go ahead and subscribe and join the Watwa family. Also, before you leave the channel, put a like on this video. Get down in the comment section. Let me know what you think about the video. Also, if you got a video you want me to react to, get down in the comment section. Let me know and I will get to it. I mean, at the end of the day, I think we've bought, well, this is probably like a more updated video, but we watched a video like this where it was talking about, you know, eating healthy and the reasons why, you know, Muslims don't eat pork and other things, and then also the reason why certain things like the Jews and stuff not eating, you know, kosher food, like they were talking about rabbits and things of that nature. So, and then Christians being able to eat pork and things of that. So to me, it's like, I mean, to me, It's like, who's the most healthiest? Of course you would say one religion, but at the end of the day, it's not about who's the healthiest, because you could say this religion is the healthiest, but do you practice that? See what I'm saying? Just because you don't eat pork don't mean that something else you eat is more healthier. You see what I'm saying? I feel like it's more so about not saying which religion eats the most healthiest. I think it's about, do you eat healthy for yourself? You see what I'm saying? Because everybody is different. Everybody's allergic to certain things. Everybody can't eat certain things. So are you the healthiest that you can be for yourself? That's the questions that I feel like you should be answering for yourself. So we'll talk. I'm going to get down in the comment section. Let me know. I know for me, as y'all seen, I don't, you know, depending on when you join the Watwa family, if you just joined it, then you're looking at me now. But if you joined the Watwa family, like, you know, a year ago, then you will see where we've came from. Like, you can go back and look at the older videos. Like, I was a little bit more heavier, and then now I'm a little, you know, I'm more thinner. And the reason why I'm thinner is because I've been taking the gym seriously, like literally seriously. And then also with taking the gym seriously, I've also been making sure I diet. So my diet, which I will, hold on, I can't say it in this video because I want to save it for another video. I'm going to be doing like a nutrition diet workout video later so you guys can see how I lost so much weight. But other than that, I feel like it is what you eat, and it's definitely exercising. And then it's also about just staying close to your deen, man. You know what I'm saying? Staying close to your religion, staying prayed up. And then also, it's also a mental thing, you know, keeping good people around you. And it's a mental thing, because I know if you become stressed or mentally unstable, then you might eat, you know, you might eat more to cope with that, to feel more comfort. And, you know, I was there. I was at a point where I felt so depressed that I would just go and eat. Like, I would just Chinese food, donuts, just all types of stuff that wasn't good. Like, hold on, you know, I still eat Chinese food, but not as much as I do. But I'm saying, like, I would eat to it was like comfort. Like, I would eat for comfort, not really eating because I was hungry. So I think a lot of us have gone through that, and it's kind of hard to get out of it. So that's just my opinion on the video. We'll talk about it. Get down in the comment section. Let me know what your opinions are about it. Also, remember, I will see you guys tomorrow. Why? Because I post videos every day. So please, please, please take care. Stay safe.